Good afternoon, evening, whatever this time of day is called. I need just a few minutes of your time and attention before we begin Mass. Bishop Kulik has asked that this announcement be made at all the Masses throughout the Diocese of Greensburg this weekend. The Holy Father has requested that each of us, throughout the church throughout the world, share our ideas about the future of our faith. This gathering of ideas is called a synod. It is a massive effort to listen to a broad range of people throughout our faith community and to discuss major issues together with the goal of hearing where the Holy Spirit is calling the church. The synod kicks off next week with Survey Saturday and Survey Sunday. A short 15-question survey can be taken online or on paper. There will be a copy in the bulletin next week. There will be one in the upcoming edition of the Catholic Accent. And it's also available to be taken online at dioceseofgreensburg.org/synod. You'll see in today's bulletin, there's an insert out there in today's bulletin that talks a lot more about a synod, understanding what a synod is, and also a listing of dates coming up in February, where there will be listening sessions throughout the diocese as well as online, where Bishop Kulik will be there and listening. So I would commend that to your reading throughout the coming week. As I said, Bishop will be at these town hall listening sessions throughout February and invite you to find one that fits your schedule so that you're able to participate. Each one begins with a short prayer service followed by small group discussions. If you remember, at the end of January 2 years ago, just before the pandemic, we did our parish assembly. It'll be very much in the format of how we did our parish assembly, although they probably won't feed you at those like we did here. But there will be prayer and an opportunity for small group discussion. The process called Synod on Synodality is intended to inspire people to dream about the church we are called to be. So please consider participating in Survey Saturday or Survey Sunday next weekend and attend a town hall listening session if possible. Thank you.
The St. Regis Parish family gathers to celebrate the second Sunday in Ordinary Time. There are two announcements. The St. Regis Knights are once again sponsoring a baby bottle campaign for Women's Choice Network, a local pro-life pregnancy resource center. Take a baby bottle with you as you leave Mass today. Then go home and fill it up with coins, bills, or even a check, and bring it back to church by the last Sunday of January. We are excited to continue our journey through the Bible Timeline program. This Bible study program breaks the Bible into 12 color-coded time periods that make it easy to follow its narrative thread. We will learn the major people, places, and events of the Bible and discover how they all come together to reveal the remarkable story of our faith. The final 11 sessions will start on Tuesday, January 25th. Please note the time change to January 25th. There is a morning session at 9 a.m. and an evening session at 6:30 p.m. New participants are welcome. Contact the Office of Faith Formation for more information or to register. Please pick up the hymnal and turn to the opening hymn, number 910, O God Beyond All Praising, number 910.
Praising, we worship you today and sing the love amazing that songs cannot repay. For we can only wonder at every gift you send, at blessings without number. And mercies without end. We lift our hearts before you and wait upon your word. We honor and adore you, our great and mighty Lord. Then hear, O gracious Savior, accept the love we bring, that we who know your favor may serve you as our King. And whether our tomorrows be filled with good or ill, we'll triumph through our sorrows and rise to bless you still. To marvel at your beauty and glory in your ways, and make a joyful duty our sacrifice of praise.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. My brothers and sisters, as we gather together to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we come to renew ourselves in word and sacrament that we may follow the Lord ever more faithfully with our lives devoted and our hearts firmly entrenched in Him. As we begin this celebration, let us call to mind our sins, those times that we have failed to respond gratefully to the Lord's presence in our lives, those times that we have turned away from that path to which He calls us. And let us ask our merciful God for pardon and peace. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who governs all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace upon our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. For Zion's sake, I will not be silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not be quiet. Until her vindication shines forth like the dawn, and her victory like a burning torch. Nations shall behold your vindication, and all kings your glory. You shall be called by a new name, pronounced by the mouth of the Lord. You shall be a glorious crown in the hand of the Lord, a royal diadem held by your God. No more shall people call you forsaken or your land desolate, but you shall be called my delight and your land espoused. For the Lord delights in you and makes your land his spouse. As a young man marries a virgin, your builder shall marry you. And as a bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so shall your God rejoice in you. The word of the Lord.
O God, I seek you, my soul thirsts for you. Your love is finer than life.
O God, I seek you, my soul thirsts for you.
As a dry and weary desert land, so my soul is thirsting for my God, and my flesh is faint for the God I seek, for your love is more to me than life.
O God, I seek you, my soul thirsts for your love is finer than light. I think of you when at night I rest. I reflect upon your steadfast love. I will cling to you, O Lord my God. In the shadow of your wings I sing.
O God, I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. Your love is finer. Your name all the days I live. I will raise my hands and call on you. My joyful lips shall sing your praise. You alone have filled my hungry soul.
O God, I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. Your love is finer. Your love is finer than life.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, there are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God, who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. To one is given through the Spirit the expression of wisdom. To another, the expression of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, mighty deeds. To another, prophecy. To another, discernment of spirits. To another, varieties of tongues. To another, interpretation of tongues. But one and the same Spirit produces all of these, distributing them individually to each person as he wishes. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. God has called us through the gospel to possess the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. There was a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples were also invited to the wedding. When the wine ran short, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, how does your concern affect me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servers, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone water jars there for Jewish ceremonial washings, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told them, "Fill the jars with water." So they filled them to the brim. Then he told them, "Draw out some now and take it to the head waiter." So they took it. And when the head waiter tasted the water that had become wine, without knowing where it came from, although the servers who had drawn the water knew, the head waiter called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves the good wine first, and then when people have drunk freely, an inferior one. But you have kept the good wine until now." Jesus did this as the beginning of his signs at Cana in Galilee, and so revealed his glory, and his disciples began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord. Each year, as we make our return to ordinary time after Christmas, some of those themes that we have been reflecting upon in the later days of the Christmas season carry over into the liturgies as we begin ordinary time. We continue to hear of revelation and manifestation and epiphany, little e epiphany, a word that means revelation or manifestation.
as it begins to be revealed who Jesus is. And there's also a great emphasis on the liturgies in this time of year, and we'll hear it over the next few weeks, of ministry and mission as well, as Jesus begins his ministry. And as we begin to walk with him through the gospel, it encourages us in our ministry as we walk with the Lord, that we also are called to ministry as well. So we hear that in our readings today. The reading from John takes us to what is in John's gospel, the first of Jesus' miracles. In John's gospel, they're called signs. The first major part, about the first half of John's gospel, is called the Book of Signs. And in there are all kinds of miracles, but as I said, miracles are called signs, and they reveal to us something of who Jesus is and what his ministry is about. You know, we know when Jesus is curing the sick, especially healing the blind, you know, it's about being released from sin. When people recover their sight, it's a reminder and a sign of people on the journey of faith, moving toward greater understanding and greater faith. And so when we hear of this miracle of Jesus turning water into wine, what does it reveal to us? It should reveal to us, at a very human level, Jesus loved a good party. There were 6 stone water jars, 20 to 30 gallons each. So if you take the medium there, 25 gallons each, that's 150 gallons of wine that Jesus has made in this miracle. So Jesus loved a good party, not just at the wedding at Cana, but as we know throughout the gospel, Jesus oftentimes is doing ministry at table. Whether they're sitting down for a formal dinner or at a party or a gathering or something like that, much of the ministry of Jesus takes place there. And that is significant. We are called, you know, we're not just little individual soldiers in our lives of faith, but we're part of something more. And so, you know, collectively, you know, we all do individual ministry, of course, but as a church, we come together and we minister as a people. Jesus calls people together. He calls people to himself. And much ministry happens as a result of that. But all of this water that is turned into wine, this choice wine, you know, the head waiter says, you know, usually the good wine gets served first, but you've kept the good stuff until now. Normally serve the good stuff first, and then when people are a little lubricated, then you can serve something a little inferior. But you've turned it around here. Teaches us of the superabundance of God's grace. This choice vintage wine is now being served, and it comes in such abundance. God's grace comes in abundance to us through Jesus Christ. And we should celebrate that. Wine, then, in biblical times as now, is symbolic of festivity. Wine is a festive drink. You know, you go to a wedding, and the bride and groom toast one another with champagne. Champagne is just bubbly white wine. You know, special occasions, you toast champagne. You go out to a nice dinner. You have a glass of wine with dinner. It is a festive drink. And so it is celebratory. It is festive. Our life in Christ is meant to be festive. All too often, we Christians, you know, we see our faith, we don't live it that way. We are called to be joyful people because Christ is present with us. God's abundant grace is being poured out for us through Jesus Christ. And so as a result, our lives, as we experience Christ and as we experience his grace, should be filled with joy. And so we should see fulfilling the mandates of our faith not as tasks or burdens. We talk about Sunday obligation. We talk about obligation and duty. But we should see those things. When we come to Mass, we shouldn't see it as an obligation, but as an opportunity to be in the presence of the Lord, an opportunity to receive his grace. as we live out the teachings of the church, as difficult as they may be for us sometimes, they're not meant to be, or they shouldn't be considered a burden, but sometimes we make them so, and sometimes even leaders in the church make them that way. But it's not about burden. It's about growing in our relationship with the Lord, recognizing that He is near us. And everything that we do, whether it's here in our celebration of the Mass, or even when we're giving things up, or we're going to confession, or anything else, we should be doing so with joy, because Christ is near. And this miracle takes place within the setting of a wedding. Weddings are recalled in Scripture, and they're images of what awaits us. The image of Jesus performing this miracle at Cana reminds us of what is called the eschatological banquet. In other words, what life is like in the fullness of the kingdom, where we are at the table of the Lord in its fullness. As we minister and labor in the church, we are growing toward that eschatological banquet. We're growing toward fullness of life in Christ. In His coming and in His ministry, Jesus, the bridegroom, is united to His bride, the church. Us, the people of God. And so as we grow in our faith, as we're open to that superabundance of grace that is poured out for us through Jesus Christ, we grow in union with Him until we come to the fullness of union when we get to the fullness of the kingdom of heaven. All that is happening and more in that miracle story that we hear. The disciples, John tells us, see this miracle and they begin to believe. Their faith will grow as they receive the abundance of God's grace. They will be equipped to minister. They will come to recognize their spiritual gifts. Paul goes through that list in the second reading tonight of spiritual gifts. It's not an exhaustive list, but it's pretty extensive. And those gifts that we receive, that everybody receives, each in their own way, equip us so that as we are filled with the grace of Christ, as we're open to that superabundance that pours out to us, we can then go and do ministry. We can then go and minister to one another. We can then be more united as the body of Christ. That's our mission. That is our work. That is what we are called to do with great joy.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. United in faith and in complete trust in God, we now bring before him our needs.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis and for all bishops and priests, that they may always lead the faithful to lives of prayer and virtue. Through the intercession of Saint Joseph, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church, that she may be united in love and reverence for the Eucharist, the source and summit of all Christian life. Through the intercession of Saint Joseph, we pray. For public authorities, that they may recognize the role of the family in building up society in which all human life is valued, served, and protected from conception to natural death. Through the intercession of Saint Joseph, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have suffered and continue to suffer from the violence to human dignity inherent to racism. Through the intercession of Saint Joseph, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase of young men and women into the priesthood, diaconate, or consecrated religious life. Through the intercession of Saint Joseph, we pray. For our beloved dead, that in the wedding feast of the eternal Jerusalem, they may shine as jewels in the crown of Jesus. Through the intercession of Saint Joseph, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
During this Mass, we remember in a peculiar way Irene and Harry Klemkowitz. We pray. For the prayers we hold deep in our hearts, which we now pause to add.
O God, you quench the thirst of all who yearn for your presence. May we always trust in you. Hear and respond to our prayers with your abundant goodness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine.
I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. Seek the face of the Lord and long for him. He will bring you his light and his peace.
I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you and you are mine.
I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you and you for him. He will bring you his joy and his hope. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine. I have loved you with an everlasting love. I have called you, and you are mine.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Creator of the world and source of all life. For you never forsake the works of your wisdom, but by your providence are even now at work in our midst. With mighty hand and outstretched arm, you led your people Israel through the desert. Now, as your church makes her pilgrim journey in the world, you always accompany her by the power of the Holy Spirit and lead her along the paths of time to the eternal joy of your kingdom through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels and saints, we too sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, Jesus took bread and said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When
when we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord,
until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and Larry, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Regis, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God,
sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 664, Taste and See, number 664.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord, of the Lord.
The Lord at all times, praise shall always be on my lips. My soul shall glory in the Lord, for God has been so good to me.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see the goodness of the Lord, of the
Glorify the Lord with me. Together let us all praise God's name. I called the Lord who answered me. From all my troubles I was set free.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Trust.
Take.
taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord, of the
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. You may have noticed during the prayers of the faithful tonight, all of those intercessions, they were interceding to St. Joseph. Our parish this past week has been hosting a St. Joseph icon, parts of the Knights of Columbus icon program, traveling to various churches. We got the word before Christmas, but because of early bulletin deadlines and everything, we weren't able really to publicize it the way we'd like to. But we have that out in the main gathering space, beautiful icon of St. Joseph as part of the Knights of Columbus program. I know some people have seen it during the week, so I invite you. It's leaving tomorrow, after Mass tomorrow, so I invite you to go out and take a look, spend some time in prayer. And there are also some beautiful little prayer cards on the stand next to the icon. Please feel free to take a prayer card. But we're grateful to have had and hosted the icon throughout the course of this week. Speaking of the Knights of Columbus, you heard about the baby bottle campaign that's ongoing. Please do not get confused. There are baskets with empty bottles for you to take. There's also a basket for you to return bottles with money in it. So if you haven't taken a bottle yet, make sure you take an empty bottle and not a bottle that's already got money in it. So just point that out. So be careful if you still need to take one. A festival meeting that was scheduled for this Tuesday is being postponed until Tuesday, February 1st. We're trying to get past this current peak of COVID, so we're trying to limit parish meetings as much as possible. So we're postponing that for 2 weeks until February the 1st at 6:30. Monday is Martin Luther King Day, so the office will be closed on Monday. Probably would have been closed anyway, because we get all that snow they're talking about. We're going to be closed. So I would mention to all of our daily Mass people, I live here, so I'll be here on Monday morning, but there's a foot of snow. I do not expect you to be here for Mass on Monday morning. But please be prudent. And if you have to be traveling tomorrow, Monday, please do exercise caution and be very careful. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass has ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another.
Our closing hymn is number 909, Glory and Praise to Our God, number 909.
Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of him who built the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. In his wisdom he strengthens us like gold that's tested in fire. Though the power of sin prevails, our God is there to save. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. Every moment of every day, our God is waiting to save. Always ready to seek the lost, to answer those who pray. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways.